key cloth, the cloth used on the keyboard, on the action of Beethoven's piano, that was missing. But I was able to find the right material at a surplus store. Now this, again, wasn't used for piano, it wasn't made for pianos, but it was actually part of a coat. And you see, I have this coat, it's absolutely the right material, the right thickness, the right color. So what I had to do was buy up their entire supply, because I know I'll never be able to get it again. And I often do that. When I find the right supplier, I just buy a lifetime supply, because you never know when it's going to become unavailable.
The piano is carefully wheeled into the great hall at Ford Abbey, under the watchful eye of removal specialist Colin Batt.
It's a great honor to be able to move Beethoven's piano. It really is a privilege. These opportunities only come up very rarely, so we are very honored to be entrusted with the responsibility of transporting it from place to place. We got the job because we specialize in moving pianos of all ages, and because of its age and value, it has to be transported horizontally in a specially constructed case. And this caused a few problems with wheeling it in and out of venues, so we had to construct a special trolley. Once we agreed on this, we went on to the basis of the moving it from one venue to the other. Because of the insurance value of $5 million, there's obviously quite a security risk. So we thought it would be better to keep the vehicle moving continuously between venues wherever possible. If we have to stop, there are two men that sleep in the lorry the whole time. So hopefully minimizing any risk of theft or anything else.
At last, the piano is unwrapped. It looks perfect, but the chief concern is how it sounds.
It's amazing, it sounds. I mean, considering the journey it's been through, it's only slightly out of tune, and it seems to be working fine. I was in a lot worse shape after the journey than this is, it seems to be. So. Now I just want to check over the soundboard, make sure no problems with the soundboard, and that everything's really just absolutely fine. It has traveled without any difficulty at all. I see absolutely no problems. You know, I wanted to look, make sure that there were no cracks in the soundboard or anything like that. And it's really fine. So obviously the spirit of Beethoven is watching over it. There's no question. So I'm very relieved.
Virtuoso Melvin Town recorded 6 of Beethoven's bagatelles at Ford Abbey.
It is a very typical Broadwood piano of that period. It differs from a modern piano in that the touch and the sound is much lighter. Particularly the touch of the piano, the key depth is much, much shallower than that of a modern piano. But it's really a sort of in-between instrument between the Viennese pianos of that period, which is what Beethoven had for most of his life, as did Haydn and Mozart and Schubert and Schumann, and the modern piano. So the Broadwood pianos are really a sort of in-between the very, very light Viennese pianos, which are very delicate, very light, incredibly difficult to play. Then the Broadwoods, and then the modern pianos. And it's, in fact, it's what the modern piano action derives from, is the Broadwood.
We find over and over again that when you play these instruments in the way that they were played, the essence of the music seems to come out that much better. It's not surprising, really. I mean, if it was written for certain instruments and they were played in a certain way, it's not surprising that that happens. But it's always a bit of a shock when you actually do hear his music on the, so to speak, the right instruments, because certain things just fall into place, and beautiful sounds come out, but also balances work out very well as well. So it's a very interesting business to try and use these old instruments, at least some of the time in one's career.
It's a real treat for me to be able to play it, not only the piano itself, but because it's been very, very well restored by David Winston, and I think it's probably in a much better state than Beethoven ever knew it. So I'm even luckier, I think, and I feel that Beethoven's towering over me, saying, I wish I could have had this piano as good as it is now.